Welcome to Excel Magic Trick number 209. Hey, if you want to download this workbook and follow along, click on my YouTube channel, then click on my college website link, and you can download the workbook, Excel Magic Trick 203 to 210. Hey, in trick number 209, we want to talk about the difference between a formula and a function. We're actually going to be talking about semantics. Words. The reason why is because oftentimes when people talk about Excel, they use the word formula or function incorrectly, or they mix them up. So let's just see what a formula is and what a function is. All right, here we have an APR, and we have monthly payment. So we want to calculate our EAR. Now, a formula will allow us to do things like math, or extract data, or create a text string. I actually have a bunch of notes over here from the book I wrote about what a formula is. I always define a formula as anything in a cell where the first character is an equal sign. So here we'll construct a math formula for EAR, effective annual rate. Open parentheses, 1 plus this cell right here, divided by 12, close parentheses. Now, with formulas, you can put lots of things in them. Here's a cell reference. Here's an operator, a plus, and here's some numbers. You only want to hard code numbers in when they're not going to change. Number of months in a year is not going to change anytime soon. If the numbers can change, then of course you put them in a cell and refer to them. Now we'll do caret, which is shift 6, 12, minus 1. There it is. That's a formula. It's going to do some math calculating. Now, what is a function? Hey, let's do the effect function equals effect. Our nominal rate is this, and our comma, NPERY, is going to be 12. Now, wait a second. I thought I already said that a formula is anything with an equal sign as the first character in the cell. Boom, that is correct. This is a formula, but we're using a function in our formula. So there you go. Now, what about if we wanted to create a text string using a formula? So far, we've had a formula doing math. We've had a formula doing a function. Now, can we do a text string? Sure. We could say equals, and then in quotes, the EAR is space, end quote. Now, we're going to join things together. So I'm going to use the ampersand. And, well, what do we need? This is a text string in quotes. This is an ampersand that allows us to join. We want this right here. Well, let's just click on this right here and then hit Enter. So right in this formula, we're using some text and a cell reference and an ampersand. Ooh, yuck. So let's click our F2 key here to put it in edit mode. And we use the text function. The text function, see, we're using a function and a text string. And this is a formula. Hey. Wait a second. You mean in a formula, there's an equal sign, right? We can use a function and other stuff? You betcha. The text function will take this value, and if we tell it what sort of formatting we want, comma, in this case it's percent custom number formatting, and you have to put it in quotes, 0.00, and then a percent symbol, end double quote, close parentheses. Now one, so there's a formula with a text string and a function. I'm going to hit Enter. Now what about doing math? Can you use a cell reference and a function? Sure you can. How about this? Equals this one right here. We want to calculate the deviation. So we'll minus our average, subtract our average. So there's an example of a formula. Still is a formula, equal sign, the first character. But we're using a cell reference, an operator, and a function. So to sum this up, this part is the function. The whole thing is a formula. This part is the function. The whole thing is a formula. There is a formula, but it only has a function. And there's a formula with just some operators, numbers, and cell references. Formula, function. Don't mix those words up, because we like to be able to talk to each other about how cool Excel is and the formulas and functions. All right, we'll see you next trick.